Okay, I think we are going to start the seminar today. And we have Dr. Mizuno-san. He is coming from the University in Frankfurt. He is now working within the Black Hole Camp project that you may know that it got a huge funding grant from the European Union to study black holes. And it is composed by three main groups in two in Germany, one in Holland. And Giuseppe is working in the group with Luciano Rettore. And he is one of the, I think, more renowned experts on general relativity simulations of relativistic fluids. And he got his PhD in Kyoto University in 2004. And then after some small period of postdoc in Kyoto, he moved to the United States and where he spent 6 years working at the University of Alabama together with Kenichi Nishikawa, funded by NASA and NSF. And then he spent also some time as a postdoc in Taiwan, and then he moved to, as I said before, to Goethe University in Frankfurt in 2014. So today he is going to talk about magnetic fields in stability in relativistic physics.
Thank you for the introduction, and also thank you for the give a chance to talk to here. So today I'm talking about for the, my recent highlight of the, my work with the relay for the stability of the relative jet to using for the magnetic field at MHD. So the, I'm Yosuke Mizuno, and in the Black Hole Camp collaboration, and mostly the theory team. So in the content today, I little bit talking about for the introduction for the relativistic jet and also instabilities. Then we are talking about for the each instability by the current-driven kink instability in the relative jet, and this is considered a strongly magnetized regime. And second one talking about for the Kelvin-Helmholtz instability in the relative jet, also this is a weakly magnetized regime. Then, also we, my most recent work related for the recollimation shock in the relative jet, this is working with the FOSSE here. Then also if I have a time, so I try to give a, some talk about for the new development of the new general relativistic MHD code, and also the coupling with the general relativistic radiation transfer calculation. This is based on to the Black Hole Camp project. So the, I think it's also a person known to the relative jet. So the relative jet is a tremendous elongated collimated outflow of the plasma with a relative speed. So the relative speed means the jet speed is near to the right speed. So the many sources for the relative jet we can see from to the stellar side to the extragalactic side. Then the most well known and well observed is the object is the M87 jet. This is a radio galaxy. And then, so this is the most largest size scale. This is the jet, and then this is making for the multi-wavelengths. We can see this is the X-ray, the optical, and the radio. Then, the, if you consider the BABI interferometry, we can see the most smallest size of the jet inside structure. So now it's, this is, we see still we can see to the nice jet-like structure inside here. So we see jet and what outflow is a common in the universe, and then we believe that the jet is launching from the accreting a compact object, and mostly the center part is a black hole if considered relativistic jet. And then so that now it's observed relative jet at mostly at a large scale, and the kinetic energy is dominated. Okay, so that this is the most recent highlight about for the M87 jet structure. So that this is showing for the distance from the core of the VABI, and then this is the jet radius that we can consider that this is how jet size is changing here. So you see this is one line is coming here, and then this is changing for the shape of the here. So before to that, this point, we say this is the parabolic streamline nicely fit to this line. So we think this is a, some external confinement working. This is based on the, some theoretical or numerical point of view. And then, so this transition is streamline, it's occur beyond to the gravitational influence of supermassive black hole, because this is clearly matched to the bonding radius point. Then after that, it's making for the conical type of set. This is mostly expanding the jet-like structure. Then, so this transition point This is making for some overcorrelation structure, and then this is also matched to the HST, stationary knot region. So we think this region is making for some jet recorrelation has happened here. So this is current viewing to the relative jet. So the from the theoretical point of view, so the most of person believe relative jet is formed and accelerated by the macroscopic plasma process. We say this is a magnetic hydrodynamic process, and with a helically twisted magnetic field. So this is simple picture we can see it here. So this is centered black hole, and then this is rotating for the accretion disk. Then magnetic field is anchored to the one of the accretion disk. So this is magnetic field is twisted up around the, this rotation of the disk. Then so this twisted up the magnetic field is trying to propagate around the jet. And then so this twisted magnetic field also have a magnetic pressure. So this is pushing up to the jet to make matter to making for the jet. And then so that this collimation is also formed near the central black hole, and then accelerated up to the Lorentz factor gamma is more than around to the 5%, but it depends on to that case. But it has a problem. So this is the most of energy is remain in the pointing flux dominated energy. So but it means the magnetic energy is still dominated. And then so that also theoretical point of view, the acceleration need to take a very longer time. So if we say this is a slow acceleration efficiency, then so this is doesn't fit to the consistent. This is inconsistent with the current observation, because the current observed jet is already at a larger scale, it's a kinetic energy dominated. But it's based on the theoretical point of view, still this is magnetic energy is dominated. So we think it's some rapid energy conversion, something that dissipation is need to making for the real observation. So this is one of the emitted simulation done by the McKinney one. And then so this is showing for the my rising simulation case. It should be right here. So left panel showing for to the this is the torus structure is the density and the width of the magnetic field. The contour showing for the magnetic field strength. So inside that we set initially set up for the weakly magnetized torus, and then this is making for the MRI magnetic rotation instability occur inside the torus, and then making for some turbulent structure. Then so the magnetic field is accumulated around the black near the center of the black hole region, and then this is made to the very strong magnetized region. Right panel is showing to the this is plasma beta. The plasma beta is gas pressure over to the magnetic pressure. So it means to the this red color region is still gas pressure is dominated, but this blue region, light blue region, is a magnetic energy strongly dominated region. So near the black hole region, we have a very strong pointing flux dominated region is made up based on to the, this GR MHD simulation. Okay. So this is the current schematic picture about for the region of the jet, AGN jet. So mostly the jet is launched near the black hole region, and then this is propagated along to the jet, and this is jet collimation and acceleration region. Then this is pointing flux is dominated. And then somewhere we have some transition regions happen, and this is maybe related for some recollimation shock position. And then after that we have a kinetic energy flux dominated region, and then this maybe magnetic field something turns up. So the dissipation of the relative jet. Now we have a 1, 2, 3, 4 type of the categorized is happen. So why the shock? So if we consider the time-dependent energy injection from to the jet at the jet base, we have some internal shock is happen. And then if this is changed for the some external medium spatial structure, we have a recollimation shock is happen. Also we talking about later. Then another one is the magnetic reconnection. So the magnetic field is some reverse or some the deformation of the ordered magnetic field, maybe magnetic reconnection is occur. Then so magnetic reconnection is easy to convert the magnetic energy to the plasma kinetic energy. So the MHD instability, we consider the several type of MHD instability is potential growth in the relative jet. And then it's making for the turbulence in the jet, and then also this turbulence may be related for the happen for the magnetic reconnection to the trigger in the jet. So turbulence is also making for the some image instability, and this is related for the same. So this is four type of the dissipation is we considered. So this is the key question for the jet stability. So that if jet is propagate outward, Currently, there are possibility to grow the two major instability. So why the Kelvin-Helmholtz instability? So this is important as the shearing boundary flowing to the jet and the ambient medium. Then, so this Kelvin-Helmholtz instability is usually happen for the kinetic energy is dominated region. So magnetic field weaker region it happen. So it means that this is a bit further region in the jet. And then second one is the current-driven instability. So that this is also important in the existence of the twisted, or that this is helical magnetic field. So that this twisted magnetic field is expected from the jet formation simulation, and also MLTD simulation theory. Then mostly the MECON 1 mode, we say this is the kink mode, is the most dangerous in the such a system. And then so this region is important in the pointing flux dominated region. So if we say this is more near the jet acceleration and the launching region, it's, this instability is more important. So the question is, how does the jet remain sufficient stable? Because the current observation, we see that very long time scale, that scale, we see the jet is still propagating out. And also, what's the effect of structure of the instability in a particular jet configuration? So we try to answer this question through the three-dimensional relativistic MLTD simulation. So at the first, I talking about for the current-driven kink instability. So this is strongly magnetized regime, so we consider this region here. Okay, so kink instability is a well-known instability in the laboratory plasma, mostly the tokamak and also the astrophysical plasma. So sun, jet, or the pulsar is also considered that. So if configuration with a strongly toroidal magnetic field in the current-driven kink mode is unstable, and then this instability exceeds large-scale helical motion and then strongly distort or even disrupt the system. So this is schematic picture we can show into the current kink instability. So now it's showing that this is the current is propagating along this region, and then this making for the toroidal magnetic field. If we have some kink structure here, so this magnetic direction of the magnetic field becomes stronger, and but this side of the magnetic field becomes weaker. It means this magnetic field this magnetic pressure is strong and weak. This magnetic pressure is pushed to this direction. So this type of the kink is increased with the time to time. Then after that, it's making for the nonlinear stage. They're making for the helical type of structures made up. So this is one of the kink instabilities showing in the experimental plasma in the laboratory thing. So we did clearly see into the helical structure here. So we see this kind of the instability is disordered to the magnetic field structure, and then it may be triggered to the magnetic reconnection inside the jet. So the previous work for the kink instability, so mostly relativistic force field configuration, and analytical study is provided a condition for the instability or not. So the but it's very little say about for the impact for the instability on the system. So the usually the instability, the potential distance kink mode is happened, and then but this is for a linearly growth and then tend to the nonlinear stage later. So we need investigate to the detail of the nonlinear behavior of this kink instability inside the relative jet through to the numerical simulation. Based on to that, this work, I also doing for the several papers published related for this concept and using for the different type of configuration. But today I'm talking about for this most recent one, so the rotating cylindrical relative jet case here. So before to go into the simulation result, I little bit spent about for the what doing for the MHD simulation, mostly the general relativistic MHD simulation, what we do. So first, we are considering that this is showing for the four-dimensional general relativistic MHD equation. So this is using for the conservation law of the particle number. This is the conservation law of the energy momentum. So T mu nu is the energy momentum tensor. And then this is the Maxwell equation comma, the both. Then now currently we assuming for the ideal MHD, the condition is considered here. And then metric has already written into the ADN form. We consider the 3+1 formalism type of things. Then closing for the equation, we need either some part of the equation state, but now it's using for the ideal equation state. This is most for a simple case here. But this equation is, of course, it is a four dimension. So it means the time and the space component, everything mixed up. So to get in for the time evolution of the MHD simulation, we need to divide the time component and also the spatial component. So we say this is a 3 plus 1 formalism to making for the, this divide the, this component. So after that, it's making for the, this divide component. This is, we can write for the, this conserved form. This is with the time derivative part plus the spatial derivative part and plus the source term. Source term is mostly related for the how curvature is changing for the structure inside the simulation. Then, so the primitive variable is that usually we can try to get in for the density, velocity, and the gas pressure, and also magnetic field with each time step. But the simulation code is now using for the conservative form. So conservative form is making for the some density time to the time component of the four velocity, and also this is the one of the component TTJ, this is the momentum density part, and then TTI component is related for the total energy density part, and then magnetic field. So the momentum density and the total energy density is everything coupling with this primitive variable. So because the density, velocity, or gas pressure, or magnetic field, so we need each time step we can timeable from this conservative variable, then we can get in for the primitive variable each time step. So this is the most simplest, and then this type of the equation is very similar to the what we do inside of the Newtonian MHD simulation. So any kind of Newtonian MHD type of the method, we can apply for the, this kind of the equation. So as I recently developed for the, my general relativity set MHD code, code name is Lysin. So the Lysin code is using for the conservative high resolution shock capturing scheme. And this is one of the Goldman type scheme to solving for the three dimensional other general relativity MHD equation. But still, this is a metric static. We doesn't solving for the any Einstein equation. Yeah. So the program language is written in the Fortran 90. And then so we have several different things, so usually multi-dimensional, 1D, 2D, 3D we can do. And then so changing for the metric, we can switch in for the special relativity to the general relativity thing. And then for the, we also including for the many numerical scheme to consider the reconstruction, Riemann solver, or some other things, but you don't need so much detail about that. And then good things that my code is fully parallelized using for the MPI message passing thing. So this is a very high parallel computing we can do there. So and then this code is, this is mostly public available. So if you want to use it for the, my course, so please contact me. I can give you the Discord. Okay, so the back to the simulation. So the here we are doing for the influence of the jet rotation, the bulk motion, the stability and nonlinear behavior of the current and kinking stability. And then so we consider the differentially rotating to the relative jet. This is motivated from the analytical work of the pointing cloud dominated jet by to the Lebowski 2009 here. So this is the simulation result one here. So this is showing for the color is showing for the density contour. And the line is a bit difficult to see, but this is showing for the magnetic field line. So that we assuming for the initially put onto the cylindrical jet, but this is also with the rotation and also helical magnetic field. And then, so this is jet direction here, and then we assuming for the periodic boundary box. So we jet it propagate outside here and come back to inside. Okay. So that also, we put onto the some small perturbation to the jet, and then this jet part, then it's making for the kinking instability with the time. So this small displacement of the initial force-free helical field is making for the twisted type of magnetic filament after that around to the as contour with this is n equal 1 mode. N equals, so now we say this is axial mode number, we say this n. And then this is helical structure, we say this is m equal 1. So m equal 1 is the kinking mode. So this is with the time, still just slowly growing, and then this is suddenly changing for the, this structure to lead to the propagation here. And then also this kink structure, it's propagate along to the jet direction. So this is also propagating over there, and then radial direction also this is increase. Then so this propagation speed is around the 0.1c, this is initial the mostly the maximum axial drift velocity to this related for the initial setup for the, my simulation. Next is showing for the dependency of to the jet rotation velocity. So that if this is omega equal 1, 2, 4, 6, so it means that larger omega is getting for the faster jet rotation with a faster jet speed. So that this is showing for the kinetic energy to here, and then this is magnetic energy to here. So that this is mostly getting for the linear growth time, and then this is tend to the nonlinear state after that. Then showing for the any kind of this faster rotating case, still this linear growth slope is very similar. So it means the growth rate of Hinkson Hamming doesn't depend on the jet rotation velocity kind. And then so this estimate of the growth rate is typically 0.1 rpm velocity over to this is the pitch number here. So usually, so this is a linear growth and tend to the nonlinear state. We see it around for the 120 RPM time scale. It means that a bit larger, we need concept to happen for the kinetic instability later. So this is previously showing for the growth rate. Now it's showing for the 3D structure. So this is omega 2, 4, 6. This is increase for the rotation of the jet. But the omega equal 2 case is very, very similar to the previous one. So we doesn't see any differences. But if this increase to the this is jet rotation, now we see to the n equal 1 and n equal 2 models here. So it means the different the kink mode and the axial mode is now is come up. Then so this two different axial mode is coupled with each other later, then making for the more drastical interaction and mostly this broken up for the jet type structure after that. Simulation. And then if changing for the magnet field configuration, what will happen? So now let's think about this is alpha parameter is one of the setup for the helical helical magnet field structure. So if this is going to the lower than one, it means the poloidal magnet field dominated after the larger scale. So if this is going to the smaller and smaller, so it means the poloidal magnet field more dominated after the region. So the kink instability is mostly stop anything. So it means that initially a kink instability happen and making for the helical structure like this, but longer time scale, it doesn't evolve anything. Just keeping for the this kind of structure. So we say this is kink instability the saturated and it is stabilized. So the based on this poloidal magnetic field. So the previous is showing for the this is the temporal behavior of the magnet kink instability. So next talking about for the spatial property of the kink instability things. So the simulation setup is the same, but one different is considered about for the non-rotating jet, and also we consider that this is only put onto the jet and the perturbation, and it doesn't put in any periodic boundary case. So this is a simulation result. So this is different time, t equal 50, t equal 90, and then this is color showing for the density, and then white line showing for the magnetic field, and then this is showing for the color showing for the velocity part. So you see to that initially we can put on the precession perturbation from the jet inlet region, then we see to the helical structure many times from here. Then so this helical kink structure is propagated onto the jet and then make it changing for the nonlinear stage and then making disrupted to the jet structure afterward. So if you see to the jet structure velocity structure, we see clearly jet propagation is around here at the velocity, but mostly the nonlinear stage of the kink instability is made up, so the velocity structure is very complicated structure here. So also I changing for the some really bit structure of the initial setup. So first is showing for the this is radially decreasing density. We say this is a heavier jet. It means the same type heavy high density outside the low density. And then opposite side here, this is same type more light jet, and outside it's a higher density region. So if you see to the here, so the A equal to the another parameter to here. So this is A equal to the position to the maximum of to the toroidal magnetic the position. Then so the RJ is the jet boundary region, because this region is jet is happen outside, doesn't have any jet probe. So if this is the RJ is inside of the A, so we see only to the kink which doesn't propagate along to the jet. This is happened to only one point, and this is growth at the same point. So if RJ is larger than A, this is propagated around the jet, and then this is evolved. So if considered to the lighter jet case, we see to the some kink instability happen, but it doesn't evolve after that. So this is mostly stabilized to the jet, the king. So still this is helical structure made up, but this is only propagation around the jet. So we just longly it's stable after that. Okay, so this is the king instability work. Then next talking about the Kelvin-Helmholtz instability, since this is a weakly magnetized regime. So the previous work is considered Kelvin-Helmholtz instability is stable if into the subalpinic jet regime. It means magnetic field very, very strong case. But if the observed jet is kinetic energy dominated, it means the magnetic field is weaker than the jet is superalpinic. But so the relative jet is sometimes, every time it's unstable to the Kelvin-Helmholtz instability, this is my question. So we consider the new idea is put on here. So we see if jet will have two fluids, this is spine, this component is happen, what happened here? So this is a simulation result. So we doing for that, initially this is same. First, a cylindrical superalpinic jet is put onto the simulation box, and then put onto the perturbation and from here. And then in this case, we consider only parallel magnetic field because the kink instability is, doesn't happen. So this is stabilized against the kink instability. And then for the put on the precision, this is showing for the weakly magnetized case, and this is mildly magnetized case. And then this is no wind. This is only for a single wind jet, and with ambient medium, it's just stable. And then this is right hand side showing for the external wind case. It means that spine and the cis component. So the two jet flow components included here. So that if see to the here, so no wind single jet with a weakly magnetized, with a Kelvin-Helmholtz instability is growing, and this is broken around to the here. But if consider to the spine cis state, still this is the growth rate, still looks like growth, but growth rate is still decreasing. So if consider the magnetites, of course the magnetic field is also stabilized to the Kelvin-Helmholtz instability. So even for the single jet, but still this is, looks growing. But if consider to the two-wind spine structure, Kelvin-Helmholtz instability completely stabilized. So it's more clearly it is into the one-dimensional flow. This is the radial velocity. So this is no wind and weakly magnetized, this is a wind case, this is strongly magnetized case, this is no wind, and this is a spine cis case. So spine cis, a stronger magnetized case is clearly dumped to the, this initial part of Kelvin-Helmholtz instability inside here. Then we found the new criterion for the dumped Kelvin-Helmholtz. So this is only for the relative velocity, which is the jet and external medium, it's lower than to the surface alpha velocity speed. Then this is Kelvin-Helmholtz instability stabilized even for the jet super alpinic case. Okay, so next talking about for the transition region, so recollimation shock. So the recollimation shock is here. So if many relative states, we can see to the moving emission future in the jet. So it is related for the moving shock, it's along to the relative jet. But sometimes we can see the quasi-stationary emission future. It's showing for the AGN, typically the M87. It's showing for the HST1, and the BLR or CTS1 or 2 or some other also object seen. So we say this is related to standing stationary shock. So this standing stationary shock with relative jet, we see this is recollimation shock. So what's a recollimation shock? So the dynamics of jet is strongly affected by the small difference of pressure between jet and ambient medium. So if ambient pressure decreases when the jet propagates, the pressure mismatches happen. So this pressure mismatch is making for the radial oscillation motion into the jet. It's jet expand and also some part recollimate, and this expand and recollimate by the propagation of the shock and rarefaction inside and outside the jet. Then, so after that, we making for the multiple recollimation shock inside the jet structure. So if significant rarefaction wave is propagated and propagated inside the jet, this is plasma thermal energy and also electromagnetic energy is converted into the jet kinetic energy. So it means that we can get in for the increasing jet Lorentz factor is locally. We say this is the RNA electron booster mechanism. So in this work, we studied how magnetic field it affected recoil motion shock structure through to the two-dimensional relative image dimension. So this is one case showing for the, this is the hydro case. So the left panel showing for the, this is density, this is the gas pressure, and this is rolling factor here. So initially we assuming for the already over pressure jet. Then so the, this over pressure jet making for the reflection wave is propagate inside the jet, and then so this two reflection wave is hit to the, each other inside the jet, and then making for the shock the later, and then this shock is also storing out that, then again the reflection wave is propagate inside. This is making for the oscillatory making this one. So this line is showing for the contact of this continuum with the jet and ambient medium. Also, this is oscillating showing construct here. So good, interesting thing is that after the reflection wave propagate inside the jet, jet is locally accelerated. So initially we can put onto the jet is called 3, the rolling factor 3, but this is locally accelerated around the 5. So that around the jet, we see the high rolling factor jet, and this is weak and high and weak. So we can see this kind of structure around the jet. So, and this, if considered to the magnetic field, now I showing for that this is the axial magnetic field case. So the global structure, this is showing for density, gas pressure, the additionally showing for the magnetic pressure and the rolling factor. So the global structure is very similar to the hydro case. So same to that, this is the reflection wave propagated inside the jet, and the jet is accelerated. This acceleration region is the magnetic pressure, and the gas pressure is low. Then this is also continuously making for the same type of structure after that. But important things is that jet is more boosted to here. In this case, now it's initially we can put on the gamma equals 3, but now we're getting for the gamma equals 6. Because so that the magnetic field, axial magnetic field, it's mostly it's behavior as additional gas pressure to here. So it's making for the more stronger gas pressure case, then getting for the more higher acceleration after that. So this is showing for the this is dependency of the magnetic field strength. This is showing for the initial magnetic field strength, and then this is the relative difference with the maximum Lorentz factor is with respect to the pure hydro case. So this is showing for the, this is the axial magnetic field, this is the toroidal magnetic field, and then this is the helical magnetic field. See? So the axial field is showing for the, if the magnetic field strength high, this is larger accelerations happen. But if consider the toroidal magnetic field case, we can get in for the smaller Lorentz factor boost. Due to the magnetic tension, it stopped to the propagation of the reflection wave inside of the jet structure. Helical structure is mostly the between to the, these two extreme cases, and then we can see to the still, in this case, we see to the acceleration to the more, which is the higher magnetized case, but this is related to the pitch of the magnetic field. So, next panel showing to the, this is dependent on the magnetic pitch. Now we can fix to the initial magnetic field strength and the initial magnet jet Lorentz factor, and then we can change in for the just only to the magnetic pitch case onto the helical magnetic field case. So magnetic pitch is now showing from here, so that this is BZ over B5. It means the toroidal magnetic field over to the toroidal magnetic field. So the smaller pitch number is mostly the toroidal field case, and the larger pitch number is more mostly going back to the axial field case. So this is also showing for relative jet velocity. So now it's seen to the here is the toroidal magnetic field getting for the smaller acceleration, and then if going to the pitch is very increased, this is getting for the higher acceleration. So this is, and then this transition is around to the 10 and the finish saturated around for the 10. So now we can make it for the some hyperbolic tangential function is fitting to the here. So increasing with interesting, this is transition is happen between the, these two regimes, between the changing for the magnetic pitch structure here. So, but this is initially we can set up for the Lorentz factor jet Lorentz factor is fit to the 3. But if changing for the Lorentz factor is 4 and 2, of course this maximum Lorentz factor is a difference. But if we can make it for the maximum Lorentz factor over to the initial Lorentz factor, most of the line is that fitting each other. So if we can measure to that this is the gamma max of the gamma j in the observation, we can directly estimate the magnetic pitches may be possible. So, and then this is also if concept magnetic pitch is determined and from the parallel observation, maybe we can estimate the Lorentz, maximum Lorentz factor around to this acceleration case here. So in the one case also that we are applying for the this kind of recombination shock onto the BLAC observation, this is working with the horses. So that now we are assuming for the ambient gas pressure is decreasing with the time. Then, so this decreasing gas pressure is making for the recombination shock position, it's increased with the position of the position. And that is also accelerated and a little bit it expands the radial. So this is around the Lorentz factor on the z axis. So we can see that this position here, here, and here. So this side is mostly fit to the BLAC observation and by the radio astronomy. And also we can calculate for the imaging thing. So this is a total intensity showing for the contour and the polarized intensity is the color and then so that this vector is showing for EBPA. So now in this visit, I'm using for the previous is a different type of the helical pitch and what kind of the structure we can see to the here. So now it's working to here. So it's the final time I try to a little bit talking about for the jet formation and acceleration region here. So the jet formation acceleration is a region is maybe possible to see in the millimeter VLBI. And then so the what we can see if the observation is outside the black hole shadow. So the what need to lead to a realistic radiation image for the black hole shadow? First, we need to know to the plasma behavior of the black hole region. And the second one is that we need to consider proper radiation process. And third one is that we need the correct black hole space time. So, to attack for this kind of information, we have a tool to consider the general relativity MATD code plus the general relativity radiation transfer calculation code. So that in the black hole camp project, so now we are developing the new general relativity MATD code, but this is good things we can include for AMR. AMR is an adaptive mesh refinement. So we can get in for the higher resolution is our interest point. So this code is named is a back code. So that this is based on the special relativity version to the MPI AMR back code. And then this is now solving for the three-person formalism to the GRMT equation in the Valencia formula. But the metric is still static. Then using for the finite volume method, and then we are using for the adaptive mesh code, and then this is now fully parallelized MPR. So the GR hydro part is well tested and worked nicely, and now it's writing for some publication papers. And the MATD part is now it's a testing phase. And then so this is simulation result that also directly compared to the other GRMT code. Like this is my GRMT code, Lysine, and over the HARM2D, this is also public available code to verify the code structure. So, we're showing for the one simulation result, and this is recording for the black hole. So initially we can set up the torus. Then, but if this is considered black hole, the supermassive black hole merger case, after the merging for the black hole, this surrounding for the accretion torus, it makes some kick. Then so we say this is recording the same thing to the going to the one direction to put on here. Then we see this is the perturbation is happening. Then suddenly accrete to the center of the black hole and then to making for the spiral shock structure here. So right hand side now is showing for the one of the shock structure here and the left hand side is showing for the density structure. So now we can see clearly see into the spiral shock structure here. And then so this is using for the AMR. So AMR it's getting for the nicely to getting for the higher resolution around to the, this shock structure. And the next is showing about for the coupling with the radiation transfer. So that now we are also making for a radiation transfer calculation using for the ray tracing method. And then so that including for thermal and the non-thermal radiation process. And then it now is fully coupled with this back code and also my Lysine code. And then this is making for the pipeline has already made. So this is the schematic picture here. So first we can get in for some physical model to explain this physical model going to the simulation calculation and then getting for the simulation data. So this simulation data is transferred to the this radiation transfer calculation code And then, so this radiation transfer calculation needs the radiation, what kind of radiation we can consider. So this is also coming from the physical model. Then each time step we can make it for the radiation image like this. Then this is different time, and each different time also making for the weekend, made for the spectrum also. So this combined for the, this multiple image, we can make a movie, and then this integrate over the whole image, we can make also the light curve after that. So this is one of the preliminary results. So this is using for the 3D recording black hole case previously showing for the, this data. And then, so this is getting for the radiation image, now it's showing for the inclination angle 60 degree. And then showing for the total intensity here. Okay. So this is showing for the initially, this is the part out that happened here. Then this is strongly accreted here. But of course, this is GR effect coming, so one side of the flow is more higher intensity. And also, we can see to the near the black hole region, we see some shadow type structure seen here. So this is a light curve also seen, so we see to the different inclination angles, so we can see to some different type of the light curve also we can catch up. So this calculation now showing for the total intensity, but of course this is getting for some kind of the frequency, so we can choose for some radio, optical, infrared, X-ray, any kind of the frequency we can choose, we can get it for some specific image also there. So this is the summary. At the top, so the cardiac kingpin stability partially stabilized by the radial increase density structure. This is non-deserved kink structure observed in the jet. And also the advection of the helical kink structure depends on the location of the jet sphere, inside and outside, and the characteristics of it, and mostly likely advect the jet motion now. See? Then the strongly deformed magnetic field via the kingpin stability may become a trigger of the magnetic reconnection inside the jet. So maybe this is related to the rapid energy dissipation inside of the relative jet. And then Kelvin-Helmholtz instability is stabilized by the presence of the magnetized cis wind, and even when the jet is super painful. This is, we're also checking for the criterion for the stabilizer. And then reconvection shock structure can be modified by the presence of magnetic field, and then this is especially helical field is a more complex substructure, and then we hope we can get for some image or some information for the polarization. We can catch up for the what kind of the magnetic field structure inside of the deconvection shock region. Okay, that's it. Thank you.
Questions?
Yes.
Is related in some way with the energy density that dominates the plasma.
Ah yes, yes. So the okay. Yes. So I think the M87 is the most nice image into here. For example, here. So I think so this parabolic structure region is a something is a magnetically energy dominated region. Then after that, this conical structure region maybe is a kinetic energy dominated region. So around to the this between to the here, we have some energy to dissipated from to the converted the magnetic energy to the kinetic energy. Then after that, kinetic energy dominated. So this picture is same as to the it's here. Here. So here. So this is parabolic stream line to here, then this is reclamation shock that happened, then after that this is conical jet type structure.
Okay, so you always expect a change in the geometry of the jet when you...
Yes,
at a certain point,
this, at this currently the most of the relative jet is in the larger scale, in kinetic energy dominated. But based on to that theory, still we can see the point energy is mostly dominated. So we need somewhere we can change it to the distance. Otherwise, this is inconsistent with the observation. Yes?
I have a question about the light curves you have shown.
Ah, yes.
For the black hole
current. Ah, yeah.
For the simulations.
Okay. Yep.
The condition length.
Yes, just a minute.
There. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Then these are the light curves. You're yes. assuming that you have a kind of uniform
yes.
disk. Yeah, there is no spot there that is.
Exactly. Yes. So the this is we initially we assuming for the initial the torus type structure, but this is, doesn't have any hotspot. But of course, in the GR effect, we have a one side of the disk is more illuminated. And then showing for the previous simulation here, this is showing up at here. No. So this is this is showing for the here. So we see that the one side jet is something the asymmetry could happen. Then this is suddenly it is dropping down. So this asymmetry making for the this kind of the motion here. Because the bright spot is sometimes inside near the black hole and sometimes further out of the black hole region, then this is making for the some oscillation type of recognition. But of course this is depend on to the angle for here. So if the above for the very little angle, so mostly the forum view, we cannot see so much that this oscillation to here. But big oscillations happen for the, this is mostly matter is accreted black hole region. Then this is tone changing here, then this is getting another one.
Yeah, what I assume also is since the structure becomes quite asymmetric.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Then the signature in the interferometric visibilities should be very important. I assume that in the closure phases, for example, yeah. you should notice them easily and they should correlate with the flux variability.
Yes. Yes, of course, this is the same as the hot spot around the disk or something, the black hole or something. Of course, this is rotating around the hot spot. We can see this kind of the oscillation sound. Yes, this is good. Yes.
Well, related to these simulations as well, or in general, my question is essentially about the possible relation of the time scales. On those scales where the jet is formed very close to the black hole, parsecs or parsec scales. Is there any way? I know that it is perhaps too early to ask for that because there is no simulation that can reproduce all the processes from formation to parsec scales and so on. But at least perhaps you have a guess about if one can infer. From the variability timescales that one can see on the jets, on parsec scales, and so on, something about what is going on the jet formation region.
Okay, so this is a very questionable point currently for me. So the of course it's first I showing for the MHD simulation near the black hole region. So we see to the so many the time variation is showing to the previously to here. I think it's better. But in so this is a very time dependent the matter is taking out the jet region, but this is related for the current observed structure. I'm not sure yet because the further out here this is everything which mixed up, and then I hope the helical type of structure may be related for the more kink instability. This kink instability is related for the more how much magnetic field strength. But the helical structure, it's decided that the scale to this helical things. So of course, this kind of the inter variability is making for the different type of the magnetic field configuration with the time the evolution, and then this is maybe around the between before to the transition region, a magnetic recognition something happen and then this is disappear and then most of it all that over some. More larger type of the magnetic field still left over to making for the larger kind of scale. But this is my experience. Right?
Okay.
May I ask you?
Yes, yes.
In the simulation for the deformation,
yes.
You had some variability as John was pointing out before. And my feeling is that for the calculation of the emission, you assume
yes.
fast light approximation.
That's it, yes.
Do we have any estimation of how feasible, how reasonable could be that fast light approximation in that case?
That's it. For the Of course, if this is compared to the size or the scale, so if this is very near, considered very nearby to the black hole things, we need to the fast light approximation, it doesn't good, not good. We need some slow light approximation need to consider. But if considered around to the, I think it's 100 to 1000 RG is more than like size, the fast light approximation is still applicable. But it's between to the here, it's also checking for the what kind of time scale we can see. So if considered for the around to the, it's hard. Of course, this is considered for the minute to hour time scale. We need to consider some slow light application should be considered. But if this is considered more longer time scale, we don't need.
Couple of more.
Yes. Okay.
very interesting data for the stability at least in the infinitely dominated region of the jet. To avoid the cavity of the instability to really grow up, you need the shear layer that appears to be the most efficient recipe for getting the jet being stable. We know from observations that even at those scales, there are significant changes in the jet direction, so the jet is bending.
Yes.
But it's still, they travel from parsec to kiloparsecs.
Yes.
So there should be some damping of the Kelvin Helmholtz stability.
Yeah.
And my question would be, how do you have any recipe about what the observations should look like in order to determine what are the properties of the shear layer?
It's a hard to think now. So of course we can estimate the what kind of the wavelengths and what kind of the growth rate happen for the Kelvin Helmholtz instability. So also this is depend on the what kind of initial jet speed. But of course the analytical calculation is a very simple assumption. We just only one side of jet or some two side jet only doesn't have any structure or something. So if you need a more specified structure, the MAT estimation need to do that. So.
Can you provide an estimation of what could be for instance, the magnetic field in the shear layer, so perhaps primary rotation imaging?
Yeah, I think
can
so, yeah.
Information
so, yes.
Or confirm or rule out in the model?
Yes, so the at least is that my Kelvin Helmholtz instability work is only assuming for the axial magnetic field, not considered any helical field. So, if considered the helical field, of course, this is structured, the growth rate is a bit different. And also, even for the very growth rate is very, very low, but still, if considered longer time, Kinkun instability may occur. And also, the Kelvin Helmholtz instability, also we have a Kinkun model of Kelvin Helmholtz instability. So, this is very mixed up of both of them, so this is a bit clear. But this different type of the simulation we can do, and then we can estimate this type is showing for some kind of here or something here. But this is possible to get.
There are no more questions. I think we thank you.